Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Holy Marriage Blessing, the radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And I'm your host, Dr. Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Muanda. And we're so grateful to be with you this week. And our show this week is entitled, Who Are True Parents? And it's so important that we realize that God is working in our lives and God is working in history. So the Bible is the foundation for God's work. God worked through chosen people. He worked through Noah. He worked through Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He worked through Moses. Why? Because he wanted to send the Messiah to bring salvation. So throughout the Old Testament, there are prophecies of the Messiah as a glorious king, as a ruler of righteousness, as the one who will bring justice to this world, true freedom, true peace. The Messiah will be the one to lift up Israel and to bring all people of the world into the family of God through the chosen people, chosen to sacrifice, chosen to serve, chosen to represent God's loving heart, which is a heart of a parent who just gives and gives to his and her children, a parent who loves their spouse, a parent who follows the principle in absolute and complete obedience out of love. The Messiah came, Jesus came to this world. And what happened to Jesus? What happened to Jesus is what is happening to all of us in this world. Nailed to the cross, when we do righteousness, we receive so much, often too many times, blame, accusation. Those who are really righteous are suffering in this world. Those who are really humble, who are really meek, are suffering in this world. Is this the will of God? Was it the will of God that Jesus, who was meek and who was humble, suffer and die on the cross? Or did he have a different purpose in mind and vision? As the Old Testament prophesies, as King, as Lord of glory, as a purveyor of peace and righteousness, of justice and freedom, that is the purpose why Jesus came. And that is why he came, but he was not understood. The people of his time rejected him. They accused him. They blamed him. They drove him as a criminal to the cross. How could this be that so much love, so much truth could be rejected by humankind? Is it because this was the will of God? Absolutely not. Jesus said when they asked him, "What shall we be doing to do the will of God?" He said, "Believe in him whom he has sent. Believe in me." He said, "You search the scriptures, thinking that in them you find life. And yet you refuse to come to me, that you might truly have life." The world refused to come to the Messiah when God sent the Messiah. And out of a true parent's heart, and this is, we're going to hear this morning about who are true parents. And the first point is that true parents' heart loves and sacrifices and is even willing to die for their children. This is God's heart, even willing to give his life for us, and that's what he did on the cross. And that is the meaning of true parents and true love. And that is the birthright and the responsibility for each of us, to become people who just love and love and give. And we get criticized, we get blamed, we get shouted at, we get accused and scolded. We put it aside, we keep loving. Keep loving, because love is the principle, that love overcomes everything, and that every person, every son and daughter of God is looking for love. And so when we give love, we will strike a chord. When we give love, we will find love. This is Holy Marriage Blessing Radio Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. Jesus came to give love, and he gave love. And he said, I am the bread of life. He said, if you eat my flesh, drink my blood, you will have life in you. I am the bread of life. What does that mean? So later in our program, we're going to talk about Jesus as the bread of life and what that means. And what it means is marriage and family, husband and wife, are the bread of life for each other. Parents are the bread of life for their children. If we don't have that bread of life, we don't have life within us. We have life within us because our parents gave us life. They are the bread of life. Your mother gave you your flesh. Your father gave you his seed, the seed of life, the flesh of life. John said, if you have the seed of God within you, you will not sin. So we'll unpack Jesus' teachings about the bread of life here on Holy Marriage Blessing Radio Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And I'm your host, Dr. Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Muanda. And our topic this week is, who are true parents? Who are the bread of life? You will hear God's word through Pastor Ruth. So let me welcome Pastor Ruth to our program. Pastor Ruth Muanda, who are true parents?
Good morning, everyone. This is the Holy Marriage Blessing, the Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And our topic today is about who are true parents. And I'll read. True parents are the ancestors without original sin. Who are the new parents of humankind? Adam and Eve, who fell in the very beginning in the Garden of Eden, became fallen parents. The new parents coming with the mission of giving rebirth to humankind are the original parents who have nothing to do with the fall. They have become one with God's will and can be approved by God. They are the parents who can keep original and fallen standard and fulfill God's will. They multiply children of goodness by forming an ideal family in the embrace of God, centering on His love. They are the parents who have nothing to do with the fall. If Adam and Eve had not fallen, they would have become the parents of humankind and would have established a world centered on God. However, because of their fall, they became false parents under the dominion of Satan. As a result, the true parents who were intended by God to become His ideal of creation were lost. The true ancestors of humankind were lost. What do true parents signify? They are the symbol of hope for everyone. They are the absolute symbol of hope for fallen humankind. They are the fruit of the past history, the center of this era, and the starting point of the future of hope, which connect the world we live in today. When you think of the word true parents, you should remember that history will be reset through true parents. The origin through which we can build a new world will come into existence, the internal standard through which Satan can be brought into submission, and Satan's domination of the external world will be conquered. Only then can the central point be set and the liberation of God take place. Therefore, you should be thankful for this great blessing which has been bestowed upon you, which is the grace of being able to live in the same era as true parents and act upon their orders. When the Messiah comes to earth, he will come as an individual, yet he is not just an individual. He is the fruition of the faith and devotion of the whole of humanity, the fruition of the desires of the whole humanity, and the fruition of the love yearned by the whole world. He is the fruition which all causes of history are connected. To put it simply, he is connected to the past, present, and future. He is connected from the individual to the family, tribe, people, nation, world, and heaven and earth. Jesus came with the mission of attaining this position as the parent of humanity, but he died before he could fulfill this mission. Therefore, in the era of the second coming, we cannot establish a world that advances beyond the old world unless the position is restored through indemnity and successfully achieved. The Unification Church has been continuously working for this purpose. The true parent is the perfected Adam, must restore the standard of the first parent, which Adam failed to meet. He must also perfect the standard of the parent that Jesus, who came as the second Adam, did not achieve. Who are the true parents that we know of? They are the human ancestors. That is why you must attend true parents as you would your own parents. Humankind needs true parents. Why is this so? For the first time in history, we are able to connect to the axis of love. This is unprecedented, and there will not be another event like this in the future. You must know this clearly. This is only one axis. There cannot be two. That axis is none other than true love. Throughout history, there has never been one person who was victorious in the name of God as a representative of all men in the world. That is why, up until the present time, I have struggled to establish the standard of victory. What is the hope of humanity? It is to attend true parents. 6,000 years ago, Adam and Eve were supposed to be blessed in marriage, an event that would have allowed all humankind to subsequently become the descendants of God. However, due to the fall, everyone became the descendant of Satan. Therefore, true parents who were lost 6,000 years ago must be restored on the side of heaven, and human beings have to be reborn through the relationship of the love of true parents. Only then can they become the citizens of the kingdom of heaven. And may God bless these words. You're listening to The Holy Marriage Blessing, the ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. I would like us to have a brief reflection on our reading today about who are the true parents. And I have a summary based on the Bible as well as from our readings today, who are the true parents. True parents are the realization of the two symbolic trees set in the middle of the Garden of Eden, the tree of life and the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, that have come to fruition of only goodness. True parents are the beginning of a new history, the realization of a new Garden of Eden that was guarded with the cherubim of fire after the fall of Adam and Eve. True parents come as the third Adam and a new Eve who have become one with God, just like Jesus was one with the Father. True parents come to cut off the root of Satan from you and me and your family by getting rid of the original sin and giving you the blessing through the holy marriage with a new seed from God, so that we can establish a new lineage of God, the new heaven and a new earth revealed to John in the book of Revelation. True parents are the advent of the second coming, the spring of life that will flow for eternity without end. True parents give rebirth to a couple, cutting off the satanic lineage, the wild olive tree, and engrafting that couple to God's lineage, giving them a new beginning and a new life. True parents, the Dr. Reverend Sangyang Moon and Dr. Hak Jahan Moon were called by Jesus and have been led by the Holy Spirit to carry this mission to restore the glory of God back to earth and in heaven. They have walked a thorny path of tribulation and with great persecution and rejection, but with unceasing faith and great determination, they have laid a victorious foundation. For whosoever believes is welcome to receive this great blessing from God of a new love, a new life, and a new lineage centering on God through the holy marriage blessing. And may God bless you all.
And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, radio ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And thank you, Pastor Ruth, for sharing with us Father Moon's, Mother Moon's words about the meaning of true parents. And true parents is an incredible messianic term, that God is our true parents, and that Jesus and the Holy Spirit are our true parents in the physical, in the spiritual sense, and that Jesus called and the Holy Spirit guides and leads Reverend and Mrs. Moon to be true parents in the physical sense, to give us physical life, the physical body. And that's the salvation of the second advent, that the kingdom of heaven comes to the earth, to the physical world. It's not a kingdom of heaven that we go to in the spirit world. Of course, we go to the spirit world when we go to the spirit world anyway. But what God wants is that the physical world be the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of heaven on the earth, which means through our physical bodies. Yes, we're transformed, but the transformation is an internal transformation from being people of selfishness to unselfishness. Transformation into sons and daughters of God who love the way God loves. And how does God love? God loves as our Father. God loves as our Mother. There's a Jewish proverb that says God couldn't be everywhere at once, so he gives us a mother. So mother's love represents God. A father's love represents God. Who is that mother and father? That is me and that is you. We become that mother and father. We become that true man, that true husband, that true wife. That's the purpose of the Holy Marriage Blessing. Throughout history, we could never become that because of sin, because sin blocked the way. The fall of man, the human fall in the Garden of Eden, blocked the way of true love between man and woman, husband and wife. So we could not become true parents. Of course, there are many great, wonderful parents. My parents were wonderful. Your parents, God willing, were wonderful. But still, we're not God-like, yet we're not perfectly divine. God's love, perfectly divine love, comes through true parents. That's the gateway to the kingdom of heaven on the earth. And that's what Jesus talked about. That's why the Bible says that Jesus came as a bridegroom. Bridegroom takes a bride. And the bridegroom and bride become husband and wife, who become true parents to give true love. That was the mission of Adam, and that was that Adam and Eve failed. Adam and Eve's mission, they failed. It was the mission of Jesus to restore the bride, restore Eve, and become true parents to show us all how to be true parents through the holy marriage blessing, the act of grace from God that removes the original sin and liberates us to relate as husbands and wives and parents and children centered on the perfect, holy, absolute, pure, eternal God. This is Holy Marriage Blessing Radio Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. I want to read something from chapter 16 of the book of Matthew. And this is about Jesus, when Jesus is talking about the bread. And he says in chapter 16 that to the disciples, "Take heed and beware of the leaven," that means the bread, "of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees." And the disciples are like, what? Let's see. He's saying this because we're kind of hungry and we haven't had any bread for a while. That was the distance, a gap between Jesus and his disciples. He said, "Oh, you of little faith, why do you talk like that? Do you think that I said, beware of the bread of the Pharisees and Sadducees, because we don't have any bread and we need more bread?" Then Jesus said, "You know, don't you remember the 5,000 loaves, the 4,000 loaves? I can make the bread. Bread is no problem. How is it then in verse 11, you don't understand that what I spoke to you is not about bread?" And then he stopped there. It's not about bread. And then they talked among themselves and said, "Oh, it's about the bread of the Pharisees and Sadducees is their doctrine. That's what we should beware of." I think there's more to it than that. Beware, you know, we don't want to beware of anybody. Perfect love casts out fear. We love the Pharisees. We love the Sadducees. But their bread, what is their bread? Jesus said, "I am the bread of life. My flesh is bread." He was talking about people's flesh. That's what bread is, people's flesh, his flesh. Now, when you say, you know, "eat my flesh," it's bread. When you eat bread, what happens to the bread? It becomes part of your body. The bread becomes part of your body. You drink wine, your blood, you know, blood, it becomes part of your blood and your flesh. That means Jesus is saying, my flesh should become your flesh. My flesh should be inside your flesh, which means I'm your parents. Whose flesh is in your flesh? It's your father's flesh and your mother's flesh are in your flesh. So Jesus was saying, eat my bread, drink my blood, eat my flesh and blood, my bread, my wine. It is, be my children. You should be reborn through me. Get new flesh, new blood from me. And he said, the Pharisees and Sadducees said, yeah, but our father, our lineage, because flesh and blood means your lineage, our father is Moses, is Abraham. He said, no, your father's the devil. My father is God. Only Jesus could say that. My father is God. So by receiving Jesus' flesh and blood, we receive God's love, God's flesh and blood, God's lineage. And that comes through the holy marriage blessing. That's why Jesus had to come back through physical man and woman, husband and wife, Reverend and Mrs. Sun Myung Moon. Created by God, true parents, called by Jesus, led by the Holy Spirit, Bible-based, the bread of life. Jesus is the bread of life. So receiving Jesus means receive those whom he has sent, Father and Mother Sun Myung Moon, Dr. Hak Jahan Moon, through the holy marriage blessing, liberating us to be true sons and daughters of God. And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, Radio Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. I'm your host, Dr. Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Muanda. We wish you a great week. God bless you. And we look forward to sharing with you again next week.